lovely Bertha. You are a lovely machine, and anyone who works with you will know just what I mean. Oh, Bertha, lovely Bertha, sometimes I think you're a dream. When we work out what you have to do, you can always turn the goods out, always turn the goods out. We can depend upon you. Clicking in the day, flashing in the night, your computer is shining brightly. Some people say you have a mind of your own, and I think that's very likely, likely. Oh, Bertha, lovely Bertha, sometimes I think you're a dream. When we work out what you have to do, you can always turn the goods out, always turn the goods out. We can depend upon you.
This week at Spottiswood and Company, Bertha is making jack-in-the-boxes. Roy is checking each box, and Tom, the robot, helps. Nell packs each toy, and Flo stacks it. It looks as if Roy is having trouble with this one.
I can't keep this one in, Ted. Push it right down in the box, Roy.
And close the lid quickly.
That did the trick, Ted. Well done, Roy. Let's see, only 20 more to make.
Oh! Oh! Oops! Catch it, Tom.
Catch it, Flo. It's getting away.
I've got it! I've got it! Oh! I've caught it! I've caught it! But I can't hold it. Come and get it, Roy, before it gets away again.
What shall I do with this one, Ted? It won't stay in its box. Ah, I see. That's because it's come unstuck. Better put it to one side till we can mend it.
Hey, don't let Bertha make any more till I get this lot stacked. I'll help you, Flo.
I wonder how it came unstuck.
A very good morning to everyone. Good morning, Paget. We haven't finished yet, but you can take those boxes there.
Be careful with them, Panjid. Yes, they're jack-in-the-boxes.
Oh, yes, indeed. I will be most careful. They're very springy fellows.
Look out, Panjid.
While Tom's still looking for the jack-in-the-box, and not having much luck, Mr. Duncan, the factory foreman, is having a quiet cup of tea from Mrs. Tupp's trolley.
Goodness me! What have you got there, Mr. Duncan?
It looks rather like a jack-in-a-box that's escaped from its box.
So that's what Bertha's making today.
Yes, but not very well by the look of things. Bertha needs more glue to stick the jack firmly into boxes. Roy, nip along to the stores and get a large tin of glue, will ya?
Righto, Ted.
Gosh, that jack in the box must have gone a long way. Well done, Tom.
In the dispatch department, Panjid keeps all the things made by the factory before they're sent to the shops. Suddenly, he spots something strange. A hole. I wonder how that happened. Most definitely something's been nibbling at my boxes. Roy comes to the store to get a tin of glue. Panjid tells him about the holes in the cardboard boxes. Oh, yes. Mr. Duncan had better know about this. There he is. Roy tells the foreman about the holes Panjid found in the boxes.
Holes in boxes. I can't have that. I must tell Mr. Wilmeek.
On his way to the manager's office, he meets Mr. Sprott.
Ah, Mr. Duncan, look at this. Something has been chewing at the bottom of my drawings.
Leave it to me. I'll report it to Mr. Wilmeek.
In her office, Miss McClackerty, the manager's secretary, is busy typing.
Good morning, Miss McClackerty. I've come to see the manager.
Good morning. I'll tell him you're here. Mr. Duncan is here to see you, Mr. Wilmeek.
I'll be right out, Miss McClackerty.
Good morning, Mr. Duncan. What can I do for you? I'm here to report strange goings on, Mr. Wilmeek. Panjit has found holes in some of his boxes, and Mr. Sprott's drawings have been chewed. Do you know what I think? I think there must be a mouse in the works. A mouse? Here in the factory.
Oh! A mouse!
Why are you standing on your chair, Miss McClackerty?
Looking for the mouse, sir.
Mr. Duncan, tell Mr. Sprott to design a mouse trap. We must catch this mouse before more damage is done. I'll tell him straight away, sir. When you get down from your chair, Miss McClackerty, will you please telephone around the factory and ask everyone to keep their eyes open for a mouse?
Downstairs, in the factory, Bertha is still making jack-in-the-boxes. Everyone is busy working. They hadn't yet heard about the mouse.
What's wrong with Tom? What's the matter, Tom?
What's the matter with Bertha?
Don't know, Ted. I can't think what's gone into her.
I wonder what made Bertha do that. A funny thing for her to do.
A lot of funny things are happening this morning.
Has anyone here seen a mouse?
A mouse? A real live mouse?
Yes, in the factory somewhere, making holes in Panjid's boxes and chewing the ends of Mr. Sprott's drawings.
Poor thing. It must be hungry.
It's got to be found. We can't have a mouse in the works. Mr. Wilmeek has ordered everyone to look out for it.
We don't have to look far, Mr. Duncan. It's sitting by your boot.
Oh!
I see it. There it goes.
Where?
Here it is. Oh, it's got inside Bertha. can't see it. Hand me that mop, Roy.
Don't hurt it. It hasn't done any harm.
Thank you, Roy. Now, come out, wee mousey.
Don't hurt it, Mr. Duncan.
All right, I'll use something else. The mop is stuck in a machine.
Perhaps the mouse has got hold of the other end.
When I say three, pull hard, Roy. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, dearie, dearie me. Oh, dear, oh, dear. First a mouse in the works, and now the mop. Bertha's not going to like this. I'd better go and tell Mr. Wilmeek that we have found the mouse.
In the design office, Mr. Sprott and Tracy have finished making the mousetrap. I have carefully designed this to capture the mouse without hurting it.
How does it work, Mr. Sprott?
We put some cheese in here. The mouse comes along here, sniffs the cheese. Yum, yum, it thinks. Some nice cheese for dinner. It walks along the board here, up those steps and onto this platform. The weight of the mouse makes the box go meow. The mouse thinks there must be a cat coming after it, so it runs forward into here. The door shuts behind it, like this, and we have the mouse safely in a cage.
Munching the cheese. Very clever, Mr. Sprott.
I hope so, Tracy. Now, where's that mouse?
We can't start Bertha working again until we get that mouse out of there.
Hello, Ted. So it's gone inside Bertha, has it?
Yeah. We tried everything to coax it out. Will your mouse trap work, Mr. Sprott?
I hope so. I'll put it down here where the mouse can smell the cheese. Now, everyone, back to work. Otherwise, the mouse won't come out. One pi square equals 2c.
Wow! Did I hear a cat meow?
That must be Mr. Sprott's mousetrap. I'm afraid my invention hasn't worked. Oh well, back to the drawing board.
I bet Bertha could make something to catch the mouse, Ted. A good idea, Roy. Let's see what she can do.
There. 4/5/9 to the power of 6.
Bertha's just made another box.
It's not like the other boxes. This one has a hole in the front.
I wonder what's inside it.
That's the mop that Mr. Duncan lost.
How will this catch the mouse?
Oh, yes. I can see what it is. Let's put it on the floor and see what happens. There you are. Just as I thought. It's a mouse house. All he wanted was a warm place to sleep. Give it to me. I'll take it home. My boy John will look after it.
Thank you, Bertha. Another job well done.
Whoa, Bertha, lovely Bertha. Sometimes I think you're a dream.